How's it going, folks? Mark from Like Minded Lunatics, and I'm here with my friend Ricky. Ricky, how are you?
I'm awesome.
Awesome.
Good to see you.
So today, we are going to take a look at I Love Rock and Roll and compare the original Arrows version to Joan Jett's version. Now, this is one of those songs that I did not realize it was a cover. You did, though, right?
I did, yeah. I've heard the original before.
Do you remember hearing the original first or Joan?
No, I did. I'm an MTV kid, so I remember Joan Jett video being on MTV all the time.
Yeah, this was one of those videos that was just iconic and that just played constantly.
Yeah.
One of the interesting things is, and we'll see it in a second, but apparently it goes to black and white in the video because Joan hated the red leather.
Oh.
She hated the red leather. She wanted the black leather. They didn't give it to her. And so she was like, you know what? I've just turned it black and white. It's terrible.
I don't know that.
So for folks who didn't know, the original version was done by the Arrows in 1975 off of Rack Records. Merrill is on lead vocals, and he passed away like a year and a half ago, I think.
Oh, man.
He said that this version was released as a B-side, but was re-recorded and flipped to an A-side status, and that this song was a knee-jerk reaction to the Rolling Stones' song, It's Only Rock and Roll.
Ah, that makes sense.
Then Joan Jett saw the Arrows perform in the UK, and this was in 1976. She recorded her version in 79 with two of the Sex Pistols, and then she re-recorded it in 79 on Vertigo Records on the You Don't Own Me album, I think came out in 1981.
So that was right at the tail end of the Runaways kind of breaking up and stuff, I think, right?
Yes, I think so.
Yeah.
So I think it was kind of one of those foundational songs for her. Sets the stage.
That's what I was thinking.
So here we go, folks. Let's take a look. We're going to look here at this version first, the Arrows version, and then compare it to Joan Jett. Here we go.
Granada production.
That's right.
Machine. I knew she must have been about 17. Mm.
Oh. The beat was going strong. That was a little creepy, Rick. A little creepy.
It's so now, corny. God.
His little, I don't know if that's appropriate.
The strutting in time, you know, like a marching band.
I know.
I'm sorry, guys.
I don't care for that.
Playing my favorite song. And I could tell it wouldn't be long till she was with me, yeah, me. And I could tell it wouldn't be long till she was with me, yeah, me. Singing, I love rock and roll, so put another dime in the jukebox, baby.
That is something that kind of dates the song, Dime in the Jukebox.
Oh, yeah.
Now, you're a few years older than me.
Yeah.
How many plays did you get for how much money? Do you remember on the jukebox?
I think it was two for a quarter. I think it was a quarter at that time.
See, I'm thinking it was a quarter for me per song, and then you got an extra one if you did a dollar.
Oh, yeah, there you go.
So if you did a dollar, you got five of them.
Yeah, you got an extra one there, yeah.
Now, here's the thing that occurs to me. His version is much creepier. I'm already going to say it. I don't know why. I guess it's because it's an older man singing about hooking up with 17-year-olds. This is very close to Kip Winger's 17.
they do have that, what do you call it, the creepy 70s serial killer vibe? You know, whatever, like from the Casey.
Kind of does.
I try to be open-minded, you know, and
sure.
They're doing what they can do, but I grew up with Joan. This is not Joan Jett. This is so corny, and so I'm just, oh my God.
You're not
God,
a fan
man.
Of it yet.
I mean, it's okay, but man, well, she just tears it up.
Well, let's cleanse your palate a little bit.
Yeah, I need it. Oh, she comes.
Yeah.
Badass.
Yeah. Now, here's the interesting thing to me. So, the Arrows, they were an English band. Hers feels more English and pub-like.
Yeah,
it's like she's walking into the neighborhood pub.
Yeah, whereas they feel like they're on, like, Solid Gold or something.
Top of the Pops.
Top of the Pops, yeah. It's like, ugh.
And you're the musician. What's the difference between the instrumentation here? Hers is a lot more raw and rough sounding.
I think the instruments are probably the same. It's just more of the types of amps and the guitar sound you get. And even some of the recording technique. But yeah, hers is definitely meatier, grimier, gritty.
Yeah.
Theirs is really kind of refined and polished, kind of like this. And she just like balls to the wall.
Yeah.
Yeah. Great sound. Dancing there by the record machine. I knew he must have been about 17. He was strong, playing my favorite song. And I could tell it would be long that he was with me. Yeah, me. And I could tell it would be long that he was with me.
Now, her vocalizations are the things that I kind of gravitate towards. Mm-hmm. So, her, yeah, me, she lets it fry out.
Now.
Yes,
now.
And then that, ow, oh my God.
And she kind of does the Elvis lip, you know, a little bit here and
sneering
there.
Sneering a little bit? Yeah, there's, right. You're right, there is a sneer.
It's great. Oh, it's great.
All right, back to the Arrows.
Okay.
It still has that riff, though. I love that
riff. Well, it does, but, like, the drummer even looks like he's half asleep. He's just, oh, yeah. What are we having for lunch today? You know, it's like, oh.
And I didn't realize that these were as close in time as they were. For some reason, I thought that the original was, like, at the beginning of the 70s.
Okay.
This was recorded in 75, and Joan did it in 79, I think.
Oh, yeah.
So it wasn't that...
Yeah.
There wasn't that big of a difference as far as time is concerned. Got up and asked for her name. That don't matter, she said, cause it's all the same. And the other part of it, I think, that gets me is just it's a 17-year-old girl that he's talking to. I know it shouldn't make a difference because Joan's talking to 17-year-old guy.
Yeah.
But when Meryl sings, that don't matter, she said, cause it's all the same. Now, you and I teach roughly the same years, the age groups.
Yeah.
I can't imagine a girl saying that.
And I have a 17-year-old daughter who wouldn't say that at all.
And that makes it even more creepy,
oh,
right?
Oh, yeah. Get the hell out. I said, can I take you
home where we can't be alone? God, is he picking her up from school? Next, we were moving on, and she was with me. Yeah, me. Next, we were moving on, and she was with me. Yeah, me. Sing it. No, it's just not for me.
Yeah, it's just, and I mean, part of it for me is probably just growing up with Joan Jett. It's like, that's how I know the song.
It's hard to go backwards from Joan.
Yeah.
Just her presence in the video.
Yeah.
Elevates it.
Yeah. Smiled so I got up and asked for his name. That don't matter, he said,
because it's all the same. Now that is creepy because that gentleman does look like he's about 14, does he not?
No. I'm just thinking that. Whoa.
And that's one of the band members, if I remember correctly. So it's not like she just pulled some random dude, but this gentleman is very young looking. So take you home where we can be alone. Next we're moving on. He was with me. Yeah, me. Next we're moving on.
And the way she sings, she's not like entirely in time in the pocket. It's a little off here and there, which gives it a nice little groove. The other video, it seems like they're like right on the please dance with me.
So
that's what it sounds like to me.
So for the non-ink or for the non-music people, what do you mean in the pocket?
Like her, the rhythms are not exactly on the beat. They're a little, she's kind of playing with the groove a little bit. So when she sings, like if your beat's here, it's kind of like, yeah, da 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 da. She's not exactly on the beat, which gives it a nice little flavor, nice little color
there. So maybe that's one of the things that I'm saying, it sounds raw.
Yeah.
You would say that it's because she's kind of off tempo a little bit.
Yeah, that's a real good characteristic of blues music is they're not exactly on the beat. You're kind of around it and it gives it that color as opposed to a typical blues song wouldn't be right on the money. Da, 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 that puts you to sleep, you know?
So you would just play with that
time. Yeah, you would play with the time, yeah.
That's interesting. I think, as a visual element too, the crowd helps.
Oh, yeah.
Because in this one, it's obvious he's talking about picking up a 17-year-old girl.
Right.
But in this one, while that's there, they're also rocking and rolling.
Oh, yeah, man. I had a jacket like that. Look at that.
Which one?
I had some jackets like the jean jacket with all the buttons and tore and
I've got
patches.
one in the closet.
Oh,
right?
No! Great
I'm going to stop it here because I want to come back to it.
But Will Ferrell.
Does look like Will
Ferrell. I don't know.
Proto Will Ferrell.
Yeah, well.
I want to come back to it, but there's something here. You mentioned great guitar solo.
Oh, it's very simple, but just kind of rough, and it's like very spicy.
Now, the thing I wanted to ask you is that, so I know that they don't play on the day when they film videos, so they'll record the tracks and then they'll...
Yeah, they'll like pantomime it.
Mm-hmm. But here in the solo... Right there, he adjusts the key. So is he detuning in the middle of that solo? What's he doing there?
Yeah, you can. And actually on guitars, you can, the tuning pegs, you can turn it. But sometimes you can also hit a note. And if it's a two-piece, which that might be, it looks like it may be a Les Paul, I'm sorry, I'm not sure. Where the neck and the guitar are two pieces of wood, you can hold on to the neck and bend it a little bit. And you can get that...
So instead of a tremolo bar, you would actually bend the physical
neck.
Yeah,
you can like bend the neck a little. I mean, it won't break, but a lot of guitarists would do that, like ZZ Top. And I think even Eddie Van Halen would do that sometimes. Like you just take the neck and do it a little bit.
So in mimicking for the video, he's probably mimicking what he had to do in the studio to get that sound.
Maybe, but of course, he's probably hamming it up too, because it is a video.
Sure.
So, you know.
So make it fun.
And in the studio, they could have... I don't know. They could have recorded it and gotten a knob and gone, wah. You never know.
So in post, they
fixed
that.
Could have.
Gotcha.
But it's a cool look there.
It definitely is. And he looks so blasé about it, too.
Oh, yeah, just
like,
I'm just going to bend my
I'm just going to bend this whole thing. Now, tell me this. In the... Dun, dun, that riff,
mm-hmm.
It sounds like they're... Are they in a different key or are they in a different...
I think I could be wrong,
different.
But I'm thinking Joan Jett, they like detuned. I could be wrong, but it's not unusual for rock bands to tune down by like a half step or something.
Okay.
Sometimes it's for the vocals. Sometimes it's a meatier sound. If the strings are tuned a little lower, you're going to be able to bend them more and they're going to have a bigger sound. I mean, don't quote me on that, but I'm thinking Joan Jett may be like... tuned down a half step, so maybe like E flat, whereas I think the other one, the Arrow one's an E, but I could be wrong.
Okay. Just can I take you home where we can't be alone? Next we were moving on, and she was with me, yeah, me. And we were moving on and singing that same old song. Yeah, we made singing. You're not digging this one at all.
I don't, man. And it's a really good song. I'm sorry. I'm just corrupted by my childhood MTV years. You know. with these guys. How rock and roll is it wearing, you know, your suits and your belt, you got an umbrella? It's like, man, whereas like Joan Jett, just knock you on your ass.
Yeah, and again, when I first saw this Arrows video, I was like, well, this is like late 60s, early 70s, so that makes sense. Everybody was on Bandstand and putting on the things. It wasn't. It was almost the same time period, yeah. So you're right. The Arrows looks like they're kind of in this weird genre.
Yeah, they got a stylist, you know?
Yeah.
Rock and roll is it of these guys just kind of goofing around in a park with an umbrella? Yeah, that's not very rock and roll. Whereas Joan Jett standing on a bar with all these people, just not, I don't know.
Aesthetically, it is a weird video.
Yeah.
So, because it looks like they're on Top of the Pops.
Yeah.
And then it's like the lads go out and just roam around the park.
Yeah. They're like, ooh, you know?
Yeah.
Look at the bunny.
That's right. That drum thing right there is always, I love, yes, it's just so simple, oh, but man, it just
all you need.
Gets your attention.
Okay, pause it. Music lesson for the day.
Awesome.
This is utilizing a technique called subtractive rhythm.
And what is that?
So if you can go back to when the chorus starts, can we go back like when they actually start doing the guitars? This is what's called 4-4 time. So it's 1-2-3-4. Here comes 1-2-3-4. 1-2-3-4. 1-2-3-4. 1-2-3. 1-2-3. So they took a beat out there.
Oh, wow.
That's called subtractive rhythm.
And why would they do that?
I think it's for musical interest.
Okay.
Type of thing. Yeah, and there's actually right before that when they're doing it a cappella and everyone's just clapping.
Yes.
The beat's in there. But then when they do the chorus here, they take it out.
Huh.
It's very interesting. So yeah, this is an example of it's three measures of 4-4 time and then a measure of 3-4 time. It's like a kind of a funky, it's probably just for musical interest. It's kind of cool.
Wow, that's interesting.
There you go. The more you know.
Absolutely. That's great.
Oh yeah, everyone's like, yeah, okay, let's go home. Let's go to school.
What a great vibe.
Oh yeah.
And then she takes off, and she's no longer wearing the red. She's no longer wearing the Eddie Murphy delirious outfit.
Yeah.
There they go.
Oh yeah. There
you
go.
Now, in the matchup sections, you know, usually I try to pick which one I like better. I think it's pretty obvious. I'm gonna go with Joan Jett.
Oh yeah, absolutely. And Mark hasn't mentioned this, but in August, Joan Jett played in Austin.
Yep.
And Mark and I saw each other. It was, hey, what's up?
Yep.
I'm thinking she's 70s, mid-70s. She kicked ass. She was like so good.
Mid-60s, I think, like around 65.
How old is she? Is she 65 or 60? Anyway, yeah. She was amazing. Tore it up. They played this. Sounded great. She didn't hiccup at all. She just went full blast. And I took my 17-year-old daughter. We're like, hey, we're going to go see Joan Jett. Why don't you come? Well, yeah, okay. Afterwards, she listened to Joan Jett for like a week.
Oh, that's awesome.
Awesome. So she still got it. I'm a huge Joan Jett fan.
Me too. Awesome. And I'm wearing my River City Rockfest shirt, and she was at Rockfest when we were there.
Ah,
and
nice.
She played at around 3 in the afternoon, mm-hmm. and it was her 60th birthday at that time. They bring out a cake and stuff, but it was like 3 in the afternoon in San Antonio at the AT&T Center in the parking lot. So you know how hot that is,
oh,
right?
Oh, yeah.
And you would have thought that it was not affecting her at all.
Oh, yeah.
Just a ball of fire.
She's a tank. She's awesome.
Well, folks, let us know in the comments what you think about this matchup. Do you like the Arrows version better than Joan Jett? Let us know if you do. Make sure you keep those comments nice. Take a look at some of our other content. Ricky and I have reacted to a lot of stuff together, and we're going to keep doing it. So hopefully you check that out. Hit the subscribe. Any final thoughts, Rick?
Rock and roll!
Rock and roll. There we go. All right, folks, take care of yourselves, and we'll see you soon.